Turning Brother-in-Law into Husband. Chapter 1: The Little Wild Cat. Monpris was one of the most potent aphrodisiac fragrances in the world. Clad in a black tight-fitting dress, Jocelyn McBride tucked her curly black hair behind her ear and revealed her porcelain-like fair face. It is said that whoever smells it will have an erotic dream at night. She stared seriously at the man before her eyes. Sebastian Davis pulled her hand away and frowned. Well, it is typical of her to be so bold and straightforward. Following that, Jocelyn draped her limbs around the man and hung onto him like a koala. Sebastian, I told you that I am here to make love to you. Are you done messing with me? Sebastian placed his hands on her back as his gaze darkened. Not yet. Jocelyn shook her head and undid two buttons on his shirt. You see, I've applied some Monpris. Don't you find it fragrant? Staring at her red and curling lips, Sebastian snorted and remarked, This fragrance doesn't suit you. It doesn't matter. Jocelyn pouted as she rubbed her head against his firm chest and snuck her hand under his pants. Before coming to this place, she had heard that this ruthless president of Emgren Group was a typical insensitive man, which was why he was still single at the age of 30. Jocelyn, Sebastian growled and grabbed her hand, which was on his belt. Yeah, Sebastian. Jocelyn stared at him with her clear eyes, catching a whiff of the middle and base notes of Monpris, which were mostly the scent of Datura flowers. Sebastian felt a warm sensation in his abdomen. Grasping her wrist, he narrowed his eyes and questioned. Jocelyn, do you know what you're doing? Of course. Jocelyn draped her arms around his neck and batted her eyes. I am going to have sex with you. You are Joanna's sister. Sebastian scowled and pulled her away. His shirt was unbuttoned, so Jocelyn was able to stare at his broad chest as she said. So what? Well, I have to call you brother-in-law. Then, she fondled his chest with her slender fingers. His collarbones and firm chest, paired with his Apollo-esque belt and tan skin, made him one of the most masculine men she had ever seen. Why are you still trying to seduce me when you know that I am your future brother-in-law? Sebastian gazed at the little wildcat before his eyes and raised an eyebrow. I don't care. Jocelyn reiterated, seeing that he had pinned her down on the bed but hadn't taken any action. She decided to take off his shirt. Since Joanne has snatched the man I love from me, I'll do the same to her. Otherwise, she'll think that I am a pushover. But Sebastian, are you really not interested in women? Like what the others said, I am already on the bed. Yet, before she could finish her words, Sebastian pinned her wrists above her head. I am not interested in women. A dangerous glint flashed across his eyes as he sized up her plump bosom. Since you want to make love to me, I'll grant you your wish. Like a peach that had just ripened, the little wildcat had a young-looking face and a curvy figure. He was a straight man, so there was no way he would put up with her provocation. Since she wants me so badly, I will give her what she wants. As he got a sniff of the patchouli scent wafting from her body, he could feel his heart pounding against his chest. Lowering his head, he was about to lock his lips with hers. Just then, Jocelyn sat up straight and hit her forehead against his. While he was covering his forehead, she fished out her phone and took photos of his naked body before leaping off the bed. As she dashed out of the room, she threw a flying kiss at him and beamed. Sebastian. See ya. Sebastian's expression darkened in an instant. How dare she set me up? When he tried to grab her, she had already sprinted out of the room. Damn it. After the little wildcat was out of his sight, Sebastian scowled and found that his throat felt extremely dry. So he turned around and stepped into the bathroom. Welcome to download Joyride APP to read more chapters of Turning Brother-in-Law into Husband novel online.